What's up, bros? What's happening? What's going on? Welcome back to another Product Spotlight video. In this video, we are taking a look at some really cool products from my friends over at Club Cannon. Today, we're looking at some control units for controlling your CO2 special effects, confetti effects, sparkler effects, and etc. These are essentially DMX operators, and we have three in front of us to take a look at, starting with the original big red button. I love this thing right off the bat. I've mentioned it in previous videos, and it's actually kind of the reason why Club Cannon reached out to me. They saw that I mentioned this big red button in one of my videos. I mentioned that I really wanted one, and they sent it over for review, and right off the bat, it's pretty simple. You press it, and it fires off your CO2, and I absolutely love this thing. It gives me flashback to when I first started DJing. If you think back into, I think, 2011, 2013, when Swedish House Mafia was like the biggest name, they always had these buttons. Not this one exactly, but essentially it was the same thing. And I thought nothing was cooler than when a big build was coming and I would see Steve Angelo just going crazy ham on the CO2. I just thought that was so cool. And I wanted to recreate that in my performances, and well, Club Cannon makes that now possible. So this is their big red button, and we're also going to be taking a look at their new The Button. This is the successor to the big red button. It adds a ton more functionality, and I'll show you guys in just a little bit what I'm talking about. It can also measure your CO2 tank levels, and it can also change colors. And we're also going to be taking a look at a bit more intricate product, something that's designed for, I would say, a little bit higher end, more production line of special effects control. This is the Club Cannon Cryo DMX controller. This is more or less designed if you have to deal with like a stage right, stage left. Maybe you're shooting CO2 not only from the ground, but also from the ceiling. Maybe if it's a nightclub, you're also controlling blinders. You can also, like I said, with these other two, you can use it to control things like confetti, sparklers, and much more. So this is a great little device. A little bit more intricate. I'll show you in a bit more detail in just a few moments, but this is something that it's a must have if you're doing higher end productions. So let's take a closer look at these three DMX operators for your special effects. All right, so here's a closer look at the three units themselves. The big red button is actually the original one, and it's actually the one that I've been wanting for quite a long time. However, this is the predecessor to the brand new one, rightfully just titled The Button. And in the center, we have the big boy of the three. We have the Club Cannon Cryo Controller DMX Operator. In layman's terms, what you're seeing here is essentially four of the LED buttons, 1, 2, 3, 4, which allows you to control multiple different units. Again, these are used for controlling CO2 predominantly, but you can also use them to trigger lights, confetti, sparklers, and much more. Really, this is just a DMX operator. And the beauty about this one, and something that I'll show you guys in just a little bit, is that this touchscreen here allows you to manipulate this controller like a true DMX controller. You can actually go in and dial in the specific parameters for each fixture. These two don't allow you to do that. This one has a little bit of control. You can say, hey, I want you to start at DMX address 1, and I want you to go to DMX address 20. When I press it, you're gonna bring everything to 255. The DMX operator takes it a step further because it allows you to actually dial in the specific parameters for each channel, and you can also program this to control individual fixtures. Now, the big red button, there's really not much to say about this one, because this one, it's just DMX channel 1 all the way up to 255. So when I press it, it's gonna bring DMX channel 1 all the way up, and when I let go, it's gonna bring it back down to 0. You can't make any sort of parameter adjustments. You can't say, hey, I want you to start on DMX channel 1 and end at 2. I can't do any of that stuff. It's pretty much straightforward. It's only one DMX channel. So this causes a couple of issues. If you have CO2 blasters that require two channels like mine, then this would prove to be inefficient. Again, this is more or less designed to work with the club cannon gear that only uses one channel. So if you have something else that uses two channels or more, then you're gonna wanna step up to one of these two here. Important to note, with all three of these, you're gonna get two things. You're gonna get a PowerCon True One to power each of them. They all use this professional grade connection, which is pretty cool. And you're also going to get a set of keys. Let's take the DMX operator out of the equation and talk about these two right here. Let's go ahead and take out our key and let's go ahead and go right into the button. Now, the reason why I love this key is, let's say you step away and you go have your dinner and you have kids at your wedding or kids at your event or something like that, or just people in general. How many times have you left your DJ console alone, ran to the bathroom, and then noticed that somebody's around messing in your computer, messing with your equipment? It's happened to all of us. So what's cool about this key is that when you slip away, you can lock it, take the key out, and now nobody can use it. So the button proves to be useless unless it's unlocked. Let's go ahead and plug them in and I'll walk you guys through the menu. Again, big thing to keep in mind with these is that essentially they're just DMX controllers. So if I go ahead and show you the back of this, you're gonna see that there's a DMX output. Essentially what you're gonna be doing is you're gonna be coming right out of here into your fixtures, and then you're gonna be daisy chaining like traditional DMX. When you're using the big red button that you see here, again, keep in mind that you can only control DMX channel once, which means that you have to set all of your cryo fixtures to DMX channel one. When you press and hold it, it's going to fire it. That means CO2 is going to be blasting out. And when you release, it's going to bring the value from 255 down to zero, which will stop the blast from going. Now, like I said earlier, this proves to be a problem if you're using more complex fixtures. A lot of CO2 cannons, a lot of CO2 blasters, they usually have some sort of LED ring around it, and that usually requires two DMX channels, one for firing and the second one for just basically lighting up the actual fixture itself. So when you have something like this, the LEDs won't come on. It'll still fire the CO2, but the LEDs will not come on. That's where this one comes into play. This is the newer version, and honestly speaking, I'm not sure if they're gonna be able to keep this one around, because this one just does everything that this one does a whole lot better. So let's take this one out of the equation and let's focus on the button. So just like in the big red button, this one's pretty straightforward. You press it and it brings the values up to 255. You can't do any parameters in between, so you can't do like 150, 155. Now, just like in the big red button, this one works exactly the same. You press down and it'll trigger your effects. You can also see that it's got a very cool LED pattern going on there. Now, I do have this on right now, but if I want to access the menu so that we can access some of the cool features built in, then we're gonna have to go ahead and lock it. If it's locked and you take away the key, you'll notice that it won't fire. It says safe. If I keep pressing it, it's also gonna say different things like go away, nope, stop it. To access the menu, we're just gonna go ahead and press on this knob here. So we'll go ahead and trigger it. And now it's asking me, do I wanna fill the tanks? So let's go ahead and set this to the value of 60. This works in seconds, by the way. So a rule of thumb is generally a 50-pound tank will give you about 60 seconds of CO2. So this is a great way to keep track of how much CO2 you have left in your tanks, because when you hold it down, the button is gonna count down with you. So it'll let you know how much is left inside the tank, how much time is left on each tank. Out of the box comes with this awesome chart that lets you know how much time is in each tank. Generally, most DJs use 20-pound tanks, and a 20-pound tank will generally give you about 24 seconds of CO2. If you're using Lynx daisy chain Lynx that Club Cannon also sells, I'll link them down below, you can daisy chain tanks. So let's say if you're using two 20-pound tanks, then that'll equate to 48 seconds, which means that you have to fill this to 48 seconds. Now, what happens when you actually go ahead and press this down, you'll see that it'll start counting down and stop right there. Let me get it to exactly 50. I do that when I pump my gas. I always want even numbers. This feature alone makes it super worthwhile to get this because there's no guessing game anymore. Now you really know how much time you have left on your tanks. Now, that's not the only thing that this button can do. It can also do a lot of other cool stuff. Let's go into the screen I already showed you. You can set it to say the time. You can set it to say cryo, fire, go, shot, and etc. This time, let's set it to fire. Let's go ahead and go into address. So this is where you can tell it how many DMX channels you want to operate. So if you have a fixture that requires two, you can say, okay, start at DMX channel one, and you can see that it does a full universe. It ends at 512. So let's say we want to start at DMX channel one. Boom, lock that in. Now let's go into N, rotate it one space over, and you can see that I'm marking it to say stop at channel two. But let's say I have a ton of fixtures and they require a ton of DMX channels. I can just bring this all the way up and it's gonna bring channels 1 through 60. Let's just go ahead and say 69. Nice. And it's gonna bring all those from the value of 0 to 255. So it's gonna bring all the faders all the way up. Another cool thing with this is that you can change the color of the LED. That's a big selling point with it. The big one that they're promoting is the fact that it can do a full-blown rainbow, which looks really cool. You can see here as I scroll through many of the different colors how awesome it looks. You have the solid colors and then you have this rainbow one. Now the camera doesn't really do it justice, but trust me, it looks so good in person with this little rainbow effect. It just looks awesome. It has a pulsating color one. You have a ton of other ones like this one here. Ton of different animations. They really did a great job programming this thing when it comes to the little light shows that it produces. You can also do fades. So you can see here, there's a ton of different patterns of fades here. I like this one right here. If we scroll down, you'll also see ring. Essentially, what this will do is it'll create a ring around the button, and this will work in conjunction with our timer for the tanks. So essentially, the less the ring is filled, the less CO2 you have. If you're at full tank, then you're gonna have a full bright circle. So that's essentially what the ring is. And you press done. And that's pretty much it. That's a full walkthrough of the LED button from Club Canon. Now, let's say you want to take it a step further. Let's say that you actually want to dial in specific values for your DMX. That's where this one comes into play. Or let's say that you have more than one special effects. Let's say that you're actually running CO2. Let's say that you're actually running sparklers. Maybe you have confetti. Maybe you have blinders. This is something very useful to have, especially if you're doing big productions. Let's go ahead and unplug this bad boy and let's plug this one in, and I'll talk you guys through this one. Let's go ahead and zoom in a little bit. So when you first take this thing out of the box, it's gonna take you to this menu here. And essentially what it's gonna ask you, how do you wanna work this thing? Do you wanna do four different zones, four link zones, LED attachment, easy angled LED? Generally, for most of you guys, I recommend that you do two channel, four zones. Now, what does that mean? That means that each one of these buttons will control two DMX channels. So button number one will be DMX channels 1 and 2, 3 and 4, 5 and 6, 7 and 8. Now, I personally don't use that many special effects at my shows. So generally, something that I could do if I want to get fancy, I can say, hey, blaster 1 be on channels 1 and 2, and blaster 2 be on channels 3 and 4. So what that allows me to do is it allows me to do some cool scenes. So I can go from left to right, left to right, left to right. Let's say I have some sparklers as well. I can fire them off on channel 3 and on channel 4. Let's say I have confetti. It's like a New Year's party or something like that. Then I can fire off confetti on channel 4. Generally, when you're working in large productions, it's not a good idea to combine your lighting with your special effects, because let's say, for example, you do have CO2 and you're programming your light show and accidentally you trigger channels 1 and 2 thinking that you were triggering off, like, you know, your par cans or something like that, and next thing you know, you wasted all your CO2 on just the programming itself. So it's great having a separate dedicated system. If we click the number values, we can fill the tank just like we did before. Let's say on button 1 you only have a 20-pound tank. Let's go ahead and switch that to a 20-pound tank. Button 2 has the 50. Button 3 has the 75, And let's go ahead and say button 4 also has a 75. We go ahead and press exit to that. You can see that all the values were automatically input for us. Now, if we go ahead and lock this, you can see that we can go ahead and fire them off. So you can see, just like the LED button, it'll count down how much time we have left. So I can also fire this one, and this one. So now you see that everything is counting down. Let's go back into our mode selection. And this time we're gonna get a little bit more intricate. Let's go ahead and do a record. So now we can actually set DMX values for up to 20 channels on each one of these buttons. Now, what does that actually translate to? So basically, I want you guys to think of this as if we were just right now standing in front of a 20 channel DMX controller. So let's go ahead and actually program, let's say, a fixture. So let's say on channel 1, I actually want it to be at 255. Go ahead and press that. Let's go channel 2. Let's go 255 as well. Now, channel 3, this is where we can get a little bit fancy. Let's say I only want that at 95. Let's say I want 4 at 50. Again, I'm just making up values. I'm not really controlling any lights right now, but just so you can get the idea, now I can store this on channels 1. Boom. So now when I press this button, it's gonna bring channels 1, 2, 3, and 4 all the way up to 255, 255. Channel 3 is gonna go to 95 and 50 respectively on channel 4. Essentially, you have a full blown DMX controller. So if you have like a moving head, you can go ahead and do some pans, do some tilts, do some color effects. You can program that all in. Let's go back into our 2-channel 4-zone mode. And I'll show you guys a couple of other cool stuff that you can do. You can change the cryo to say, you know, something cool like bar. Okay, so you can do cool stuff like that, like changing the little title there. It also has a clock built in. You can go ahead and switch the time. That's pretty straightforward stuff. The info button on the bottom also tells you exactly what everything does, so just bear that in mind. It's super easy. I don't need to insult your intelligence. It's pretty straightforward, guys, as far as using this. Again, this is something a little bit more intricate. This is something that I would only recommend if you're doing more high profile productions. If you're just using, you know, a simple production that, you know, only requires, let's say, maybe sparklers or CO2 blasters, then I would recommend staying away from something like this and just sticking with the traditional LED button or even the big red button. Now, in my recent productions, I have been swapping between these two. I've only actually used this at one of my gigs, and we didn't do anything crazy. We just did left and right for our CO2 blasters, but generally we just like to fire them off at the same time so we can use something like the big red button. Keep in mind that this one won't trigger DMX channels too, so if you have LEDs, they won't work. This one will fire off the LEDs, so this is the one I actually recommend. This is the best bang for your buck for what most DJs need. And keep in mind that these are not only just for CO2s, they also work with sparklers. This one will fire off your sparkler units no problem, so will this one as well. Now I've had these units for about 2 or 3 weeks now, and I've actually gone ahead and taken them out to some events. I've used them for both CO2 and sparklers, and let me just say, everybody has been absolutely loving these things. I've even had my bride and groom say, hey, can we push the big red button? People go crazy over this. So let me go ahead and show you what these look like in a real world setting. All right, so we're getting set up here at the Gramercy Lakeside Manor. We got the CO2 jets today, which means we're gonna be using the big LED button from Club Cannon. We got Nick over there. Nick, say what's up.
What's up, bros?
Nick, do me a favor, can you go ahead and click the button just so that they can kind of see, and I'll film it. So we have the cannons. The cannons run on 2 DMX channels. So right now we have it set up so that the big LED button right here is going to trigger channels 1, 2, 3, and 4. So we have 1, 2, 3, and 4. So if he presses them, you can see that they're firing. Obviously, CO2 is not hooked up right now. Go ahead and press it. But you can see that they trigger as soon as he presses the button. CO2 tanks are right back there. We have 4 today, and we have our little calculator here. So as you guys can see, a tank, 50-pound tank, which is what we have today, gives us 60 seconds. All right, so we got the tanks connected. Tanks are good to go. We got this set to 60 seconds, as you guys can see there. Tanks are either side. So right now, Nick, right here, he's gonna fire, and I'm gonna go over there and shoot from that side so you guys can kind of see what it looks like.
All right, fire in 3, 2, 1, go. bird. That's pretty cool.
Over here, we have the Club Cannon button, big button. What we're gonna do now is we're gonna change this from CO2 to spark. We're gonna go into our menu. So as you guys can see, originally had a timer. That's for the timer for the CO2 tank. So it lets us know that we have 10 seconds left. You can switch it to say Cairo or Cryro. I always say that wrong. Or you can switch it to say fire. Today, we're gonna go with fire. We're also gonna change the LED on this, the color. Right now I have a rainbowy color. We're gonna go with a red today. All right, so we got the big red button ready to go. We got the camera over there ready to record. So the way this works is pretty straightforward. We gotta unlock it, so we unlock it here. Now the big red button is ready to fire. The longer I hold it down, the more it'll shoot out. So here we go, on the count of 3, 2, 1, testing sparks. There we go. And if I let go, just like that. That's fire, right? So think of it, we're at a big drop coming up in 3, 2, 1, go. Boom.
Throw your hands up. I need you to scream and go crazy when the beat drops one more time. Are you ready? 3, 2, 1, go!
Bros, thank you so much for watching this video. If you have any questions, comments, or concerns about any of these products that we talked about, please don't hesitate to ask me down in the comments down below. I want to send a huge shout out to my friends over at Club Cannon for sending these products out for review. I'm going to leave links down in the description of this video as well as more information about all three products. So if you want to check that out, check out the description of this video. Also, if you want to support my channel so that I can keep making more content just like this for you, please check out the links in the description of my video. You'll be indirectly supporting me if you purchase any of my DJ crates, DJ tools, DJ sound effects, or if you purchase any of the other Amazon link products there. Support the channel so that I can keep cranking out more videos for you guys. Please like this video if you like this, subscribe if you're new around here, and don't forget to turn on that bell so that you can be notified next time we do another product spotlight video. Huge thanks to my friends over at Club Cannon, and I'll see y'all in my next one. Peace.